and we welcome you to the campus of Miami University in Oxford, Ohio. Friday night hockey on the ice tonight between the number 7th-ranked North Dakota Fighting Hawks and the Miami RedHawks playing in their second home game of the season. First time the RedHawks have been back home since late October. So glad you're with us tonight on Red Hawk Radio for game one of the series. Patrick Geshan, Jack Schmelzinger back with you here as always on Red Hawk Radio. And Jack, the Miami team coming off a split last weekend against Omaha, a very tough opponent in North Dakota, but for the Red Hawks, just trying to build on what you started last weekend at Baxter Arena.
Absolutely, and it was admittedly by Coach Bergeron a little bit of a fluky win on Friday. The Red Hawks got outshot 35-14. Still found a way to win in this one. They're going to have to find a way to win a lot here in these NCHC games. A lot of the teams in this conference are some of the most talented teams in the nation. The Red Hawks, pretty objectively, maybe not quite there yet. Going to need to play hard, play hard-nosed hockey tonight against the North Dakota Fighting Hawks.
Yeah, the first home conference series of the year for Miami, the first home series overall. That one game against Bowling Green back in late October was just a single game in the home-and-home series with the Falcons. North Dakota, they swept Denver last weekend on their home ice. The Pioneers, the number 11th-ranked team in the nation. Last week, North Dakota. This week, the number 7th-ranked team in the nation. Obviously, whenever a team plays North Dakota, they have their hands full. But why is this team so good this year?
Yeah, this North Dakota team, they are really fast. They are really good in transition. They fly to the net for rebounds. When Miami's on in transition, the Fighting Hawks are going to have active sticks. They're going to be trying to create turnovers all the time, and they're good at it. And once they turn the puck over, they are right going the other way very quickly. So the Red Hawks going to have to keep control of the puck today. Play good with the puck.
It's going to be a challenge. Very full student section. That's a good thing to see after we saw that in the first home game against Bowling Green. The general admittance section is filling up as well. Red Hawks starters are being introduced on the ice. We will join that and finish it out. And then our national anthem ahead of puck drop between Miami and North Dakota right here on Red Hawk Radio. Great national anthem performed tonight on the ice ahead of our game between Miami and North Dakota here at Steve Coach Cady Arena. All right, starting goaltenders for our game tonight for North Dakota. Zach Driscoll is in the net. He started every game this year for the Fighting with 3.5 goals against, 904 save percentage, and a shutout on the year. Ludvig Pearson back in the Red Hawk net out of Hinda, Sweden. 6'1", 184 sophomore, 7 appearances, 7 starts, and the 21-22 campaign, 2-4-1 record, 3.29 goals against, save percentage for Pearson at .892. The Redhawks are in their home white uniforms, so the red M on the front, the red numbers on the back, and the red names across the back. North Dakota, their standard road look. The dark forest green uniforms, North Dakota on the front, and the white numbers on the back, as well as the white names. Referees are Tom Stearns and Cameron Voss. Our linesmen, Eric Frank and Brent Golick, for tonight's matchup. So last year, North Dakota knocked Miami out of the playoffs in the first round. Fighting Hawks scored 14 seconds into that game.
Let's hope the Redhawks can hold them off the board a little bit longer here tonight.
That game was on March 12, 2021, and that was what ended Miami's season last year, last season. Face off, ready to go at center ice. Redhawks move right to left across your radio here in period number one, game one of two between Miami and North Dakota this weekend. The Fighting Hawks win the opening draw, take it in their defensive zone. We're going to try to get this through center ice. Redhawks are breaking up the dump into the zone. They finally get it back behind. Ludvig Pearson, North Dakota, does to the near side. And it goes to the near corner of the Redhawks zone. Pass to the line, Ethan Frisch. A wrist shot there with a blocker save to the far half wall by Pearson. Picked up far side by Sanderson. A Frisch, right point. Soft wrister in. Pearson handles with the glove. And that'll stop play 25 seconds into the first period. A North Dakota team, Jack, that has 8 draft picks on their roster. Every single forward line and every single D pair tonight has at least one draft pick on it.
And that's what we were saying a little bit earlier. A lot of these teams in the NCHC are objectively a little bit more talented than Miami, at least according to the NHL. Redhawks going to have to find a way to beat that barrier tonight.
Yeah. Chris Jandrick near circle. North Dakota offensive zone can't get a shot away. Redhawks will take it up the ice. Michael Rigish over the center ice red line, can't dump it into the North Dakota zone. It finally goes in there on a deflection. Fighting Hawks break it out. Near side at center ice is Judd Caulfield, the brother of the famed Cole Caulfield, playing for the Montreal organization and the pros. Red Hawks take it over in their own end and will send it back into the North Dakota zone. Fighting Hawks regroup. Reese Gaber, the team's leading scorer, over the line on the right wing into the Red Hawks zone. PJ Fletcher there, first to the puck. Will fire this one to the far corner. Will Cullen was on it, threw it up the boards to the left point. Where it's sent in there by Tyler Clevin, the Ottawa draft pick for North Dakota. Rings around near half wall. Miami zone forward to the slot. Calder shot off a stick out of play that came from Ashton Calder, the junior from Sault Ste. Marie, Michigan, and a Lake State transfer for North Dakota. 18:45 to go, first period. It is no score between Miami and North Dakota. Fighting Hawks lead the shots 2-0. Crowd starting to fill up. Student section's full, though.
Yes, it is. Another impressive showing from the Redhawk faithful.
It's good to see. Faceoff left to Pearson. Redhawk zone. North Dakota swats it in from the line. Goes behind the Miami net. Drazer turned it over. Constantini in front for Calder. And the centering pass off his skate. Deflected far corner. Drazer picks it up there. Flings it out to center ice. Scott Corbett pushes it over the UND line left wing, where it's wrapped around to the far half wall. Redhawks keep it in right point as Drazer slides it down the boards behind the UND net. Monty Graham picks the puck up there. He's hit from behind by Cooper Moore. And a penalty is coming up for cross-checking here, as we are a minute and 44 seconds into the hockey game, and the Redhawks will get their first try on the man advantage. Looks like a minor for cross-checking coming up against Moore, as he got behind Graham in a vulnerable position and shoved him over. A pretty ugly hit.
Yeah, and this is a time that the Redhawks really should look to capitalize. North Dakota doesn't have many weaknesses. One of them, if you can even call it a weakness, they're around the middle of the pack nationally for penalty kill. A great opportunity here early in this game for Miami.
Redhawks in the power play are 33rd in the nation at 16.1%. Rigas near half low of the puck as the Redhawks won the offensive zone draw. They go center blue line for Daschke. Near circle, Rigas tries to set up shop. Back to the line, Daschke. will fake a pass. It goes top of the far circle. Berry back for Dasky. Near circle, Rigish. With 25 gone by in the power play near post, Ryan Savage, a drive to the net. He was separated from the puck. Mark Senden pins it into the near corner for North Dakota. Rigas steals it away. Back to the left point, Dashke. Slides it right point, Berry. Center blue line, Dashke. Near circle, Rigas, one-timer in front. And the rebound shot sent wide by Berry in the right post. And his pass to the line for Dashke escapes through his legs and back to center ice. Rocks quickly over the UND line, left wing. It's dumped in by Rigas to the far corner. Sliding in there, Berry to the corner. Can't pick up the puck. Kept in, though, right point by Ryan Savage. Far circle, Berry. He's up against the boards. Goes back to the line. Dashke, left side. Top of the near circle. Takes it back to the line. It's Berry, top of the far circle now with 48 to go on the power play. Dashke, a rip. Very high slot. Off a North Dakota skate to the near half wall. Rigas to the line for Dashke. Top of the far circle, Berry walks in, plays it through the slot. Picked up Rigas, backhand shot loose in the crease. Where's the puck? No whistle yet. North Dakota emerges with it. And here comes Jake Sanderson over the Red Hawk line right wing. He'll hit the brakes, dump it in with 23 to go on the power play. And it's Will Cullen who's back in the lineup after some injury issues for Miami to pick it up and turn on the Jets through center ice. He will try to dump it over the UND line left wing, but they can't get it over, so it's back in the Miami zone as P.J. Fletcher will give it up for Dylan Moulton. Cross-ice feed over the line right wing, calling a toe drag move to the middle. Stripped of the puck by Ford. Frisch will chip it out to center ice. The power play over. We're back to 5-on-5, and the Redhawks get two shots on a PP attempt. Cullen over the UND line right wing, gave it up for Ford in the slot, and here comes Connor Ford over the line right wing, a pass to Gamer. Slides his way down the half wall to the corner and in behind the Red Hawk net. In the far half wall, Gamer will try to send it back to the line, but nobody home there for North Dakota. The closest player was 5 feet left in Brady Furter. Here comes Ness, near circle, Red Hawk zone, big shot, big save, rebound, and is swatted away as Pearson that time got his left pad on it. Goes to the far half wall, Miami zone, back to center ice. Cassetti trying to chip it forward, Pat Furner, he does. Here's Slatic all alone, far circle, offensive zone. Could not get a shot up there. Good stick by Yandrick. And it's back behind the UND net. North Dakota takes a breath here. They'll play out center ice. With the puck, Nick Ports chips it over the Red Hawk line, right wing in behind the Miami net. Drazer throws to it for the Red Hawks. Slides it up the right wing board. Slatic gives it up for Monty Graham. Dumps it in center ice red line behind the UND net as the Redhawks will get a five-man change. Driscoll plays it behind the fighting hot cage. Gives it up near corner. Little battle ensues. Red Savage comes away with the puck. And he is trying to spin his way on Moore. His brother Ryan comes in. Slides down. Hit a chunk in the ice, I guess. Gave it up to the corner. Back to the line. Drasner keeps it in. Kind of a broken play. UND lost control of the puck. As it's now on the near side of the Red Hawk offensive zone in the corner. Here's Ryan Savage spinning away from Furner in that near corner. Now we'll play it up near circle. A Barbalini shot went off the stick of Constantini and back to center. It's cleared. Here is Calder. Oh, the Red Hawk line left wing finds a break to the net. Brought down. Bodies crash in. The net goes off. A penalty is coming up. And we will see a holding call here. I believe against Robbie Drazer, maybe with 14:26 to go in the first period. A kind of a breakaway there. Calder turned on the Jets down the left wing, found a break to the net, and was brought down from behind. It will be a minor penalty for holding called against Miami, but we don't know against who yet, as no player has gone over to the box. So in the meantime, media timeout. We're back in a moment with a North Dakota power play. No score. Red Hawks and Fighting Hawks. 14:26 to go. First period. This is Miami Hockey on Red Hawk Radio. 14:26 to go in our first period. Patrick Geshan and Jack Schmelzinger back with the air high above the ice at Steve Cady Arena. And this is the RedHawks and Fighting Hawks scoreless early on in game one of this series. North Dakota power play, the 2-minute minor for holding was whistled against Alec Capstick of Miami. It was him and Drazner back on that play. Ludwig Pearson is okay, by the way, as everybody came in during that breakaway that Calder had for North Dakota. And they all crashed into Pearson once the play kind of got going down low in the Red Hawk zone. So the first time we'll see the North Dakota power play tonight and in this series. Fighting Hawks are sixth in the nation in their power play at 30.3% on the season. Red Hawks clear after the opening draw. North Dakota works it through center ice. Play broken up though by B.J. Fletcher. And the loose puck went to Jack Klementzik in the Red Hawk zone. He'll slide it back behind the North Dakota net. 1:40 left in the Fighting Hawk power play. It's Sanderson over the line right away. Can't hit Caulfield with a pass. So Caulfield will instead regain control of the puck. Send it near corner of the Fighting Hawk offensive zone. Gaber right point will slide across ice. Left point, they go to Sanderson. He'll take it top the far circle, give it back up for Jake Schmaltz. Now Gaber near circle, got a quick pass. His snapshot, patted away Pearson. Rebound near corner for Caulfield. Back for Gaber. Near half wall, Sanderson right point, walks the line. Gaber top of the near circle, far side feed, a rip there, the net goes off. That puck never got to the net, it was blocked in the slot. The shot came from Jake Schmaltz. Far circle, but I think somebody down low knocked the net off. It violently escaped at the pegs. And we will get a face-off here for North Dakota in the offensive zone to the right of Pearson with 13:30 left in the first, 1:04 in the power play as they fix the net. I don't know if we got pushed off or what happened down there.
Yeah, it looked like maybe the left leg of Pearson, but
maybe.
Hard to imagine. That doesn't happen very often.
No. Rimmed around the boards near side. Red Hawks won the draw, and they get it out very quickly back into the North Dakota zone. So near corner, skating out of the zone with a puck is Ethan Frisch. He'll backhand a pass to Chris Jandrick, and it's chipped in over the Red Hawk line, left wing by Constantini. We'll be talking about him a lot tonight for North Dakota, one of the star freshmen on the team this year. Red Savage kicks it out of the zone back to center. 33 to go on the power play. North Dakota just nothing doing here on the man advantage, really. It's Yonerick over the Red Hawk line, left wing. He'll take it behind the net to the near corner. Dish it back behind the cage. Nobody home for North Dakota. Dylan Moulton on it. Can't clear it. Went off Frisch at the line. Far circle with the puck. That's Constantini. In the far corner. Back to the line. Frisch with 12 to go in the power play. Constantini down low. Tic-tac-toe play that really never formulated. The loose puck picked up by Red Savage. He'll chip to center ice. North Dakota over the Red Hawk line right wing. It's Jandrick. Takes it to the near corner. He's shoved off it by Moulton. Jandrick regains control, fires it near circle for a pass, and hits the stick, ascended in front, a one-timer, and Pearson there with a save. Gavin Hay came out of the middle of nowhere down the left side, the left wing. He posted up back door on Pearson. The quick pass, sending, sent it to Hay, the left-handed player, trying to stick it past Pearson on a one-time attempt, wide open on the left post, and Ludwig somehow slides over for the save.
What a save, and I don't even think that Ludwig knew that the North Dakota guy was on that back door. I think he knew he was there. I don't think he ever saw him. He just stuck his leg against that post and ended up stopping the puck. A great save from Ludwig Pearson.
It was as if he reached over and out of luck.
Yeah.
Got it. Power play over. We're back to 5-on-5, so both teams 0-for-1 to start the power play out tonight. Red Hawks with a puck, offensive zone. Kind of a short-lived possession, though. North Dakota works it to center ice, and they shut down the play. Here's Sendin, chips it over the Red Hawk line, left wing, far corner. A penalty coming up. It's on Miami. As someone made contact with Sendin as he was trying to chase after that puck that he chipped in deep in the Miami zone. That's not one you really want to get. And number 24 is called for the penalty for Miami. That is Alex Murray, the extra defenseman tonight, out of Glenview, Illinois, playing in just his second career game.
Yeah, and you have to feel for Murray. You have to imagine, only played one game this season so far, has been a healthy scratch for a good part of the season, probably trying to make something happen, tried a little bit too hard there.
North Dakota right back on the power play. Right point, Sanderson. Far side, Schmaltz. His shot goes off a stick. And escapes to the near corner. Redhawks trying to work on it there. All four Miami players are in the near circle trying to win this puck, and they do. It's Fletcher who chips it deep into the near corner, North Dakota zone. Driscoll out of his net to rim it around the boards. Far side for Jake Schmaltz. Boston Bruins draft pick. Chips it ahead forward over the line. The Red Hawk line behind the Miami net. Pearson kind of fans on the clearing attempt, trying to rim it around the near boards. North Dakota gets possession, reverses far side. Schmaltz, left point Sanderson, right point Gamer. Shot in, Pearson let it go behind him, and then it went right of the right post. That one went through Ludwig, and then he got lucky the way it deflected away from the net. Sanderson, left point Schmaltz, walks in the circle. Down low to the goal line, Caulfield spun off the puck by Clement. They work it back to the line. Sanderson, a shot and a bullet there on the snapper that Ludwig Pearson gloves down and makes the stoppage occur with 10:51 to go in the first period. 1-1 left in the power play for North Dakota.
And if Miami wants to have any chance of winning this game, they're definitely going to have to turn up the discipline a little bit here through the last 5-6 of this contest, because taking penalties against North Dakota, that is a ticket to a big loss.
Tandrick near half wall for North Dakota. Back to the right point. Frisch slides it left point. A shot there up high on Pearson. He makes the save. As that time it came in for Matteo Constantini, the 6'1", 187 freshman from St. Catharines, Ontario. He's a Buffalo Sabres draft pick and a very highly touted one. Big pickup by Kevin Adams. Sabres organization. This kid can fly. We'll be talking about him all weekend. North Dakota wins a draw to the right of Pearson. 45 to go on the power play. Our circle, Constantini goes to the near side for Jandrick, right point. Center blue line, Frisch on the puck with fire shot in. Off of North Dakota stick in front to the far half wall. 30 left in the power play. Frisch, near side, Jandrick, far side. A shot in the circle, and Pearson another chest save on a high wrister. This time it came from Constantini in the far circle. Play stop, 10:16 to go in the first period, 26 to go in the power play.
And Miami already getting outshot 9-2. Looks like we're going to be leaning on Ludwig Pearson to have another great night tonight if the Redhawks want to have a chance.
It's already the story.
Yep.
Draw to his right. Northern North Dakota faceoff win, Frisch. Left point, Constantini, far circle, down below the goal line, behind the net, Yonner to Jandrick near side. He'll walk it through the circle. Fired up left point, Constantini to Frisch, center blue line, 10 to go on the power play. He'll rip a wrister wide. Goes to the far corner. Corbett trying to win the race. He does against Constantini. Daschke locks it up against the board to the corner. Power play expires. We're back to 5-on-5 as Murray exits. Redhawks here in the puck, far corner, their own zone. Corbett will chip it, trying to get it to center. He does. North Dakota there with possession in front of the Red Hawk bench during a change. Kind of messy there. Miami able to get it into the North Dakota zone. Pletsky sent it up the right wing, but we get a whistle. And I wonder if the Red Hawks get called for too many men, and they did. I think, yeah, the one line's been Brent Golick over there, who was right in front of the Miami bench counting everybody, and referees huddle up here, and we might get the call for too many men against Miami. And you said it, penalties. Got to take advantage. Redhawks will get called for the too many men. And third North Dakota power play is coming up with 9:34 to go in the first period after this timeout. No score, Miami and North Dakota. And you're listening to Miami Hockey on Red Hawk Radio. .34 to go in our opening period here from Oxford, Ohio. No score, Miami and North Dakota, but the Fighting Hawks on their third power play chance of the game. That's about to happen. They're 0-2 tonight. And another big kill coming up, Jack, for Miami.
Yeah, and you have to imagine Chris Bergeron probably not too happy with his team right now. Three penalties, two of which were pretty ugly, pretty avoidable ones. I would not want to be in that locker room following this period.
A blast from the line to open it up by Sanderson. Goes off, bodies wide. Goes in the far circle for Ford. Back to the line, Sanderson. Right point gamer, return Sanderson. Far side, Schmaltz with a puck. Left it in front, kind of a bad centering pass. Get picked off by Fletcher. And he'll fire it all the way down the ice. Redhawks will change on the PK with 1:32 to go in the UND power play. Jake Sanderson emerges from his own end with a puck. Gamer fires it over far side. Schmaltz will send it back behind Pearson's net. Ludwig out to play it. He'll leave it there for Moulton, who rims it around the boards but not out in the Redhawks zone. Gamer room to skate near circle. Fired a shot off the shin pad of Moulton. Far side Sanderson will dish it out to the right half wall for Schmaltz. Sanderson near side. Gamer walks in and he scores. A laser by Reese Gamer will add another goal on the season. Just a wicked snapshot that snapped its way over the glove side of Ludwig Pearson inside the right post. And North Dakota draws first blood with 8:39 to go in the first period. A power play goal that makes it 1-0.
And all evening so far, the Redhawks have really been trying to block a lot of shots down in front of the net, and that's great. Unless the shot gets through, because a lot of times when you're trying to block a shot, you act like a screen for the goalie. That, I think, is what happened there. Haber's shot was, Moulton tried to get his leg on that shot, and I think that he blocked Pearson's view.
Fifth of the year for Reese Gamer. He's the team's leading scorer coming in terms of points. That was his 12th point of the year. Power play goal for UND comes on their 10th shot tonight on net. 8:18 to go, first period. Redhawks trying to regain some control of this game after they've given up those power plays here in the first period. Miami in the offensive zone. Cullen trying to walk it down the right wing board. Stripped to the puck by Jandrick. Squirts the near corner. Jandrick reverses the play far side. Picking it up there is Hayne. He was hit up high by Cullen. And the arms will stay down. Puck goes behind the net. The North Dakota net. Kleppen near side for Senden. He'll skate it out up the right wing. The captain chips over the Red Hawk line. Down the near corner, Miami zone. Leaves it behind the net. For a pass there that will go off the stick of Gavin Hayne. Redhawks take it there. And Cassetti skates it right wing through center ice to dump it far side of the North Dakota zone. Near corner, pick it up in the UND end. For the Fighting Hawks is Frisch. Gave it up for Sanderson near side. He was met with some resistance by Red Savage. They'll reverse the play behind the net. Far side with a puck. Skating it through center ice. Jackson Coons to the slot for Ports. And his shot deflects off Pearson's stick, up and out of play with 7:21 to go in the first. This North Dakota team moves the puck so well and very quickly.
Yeah, quickly, tape to tape. It's almost like they have the puck on a string between them. And they're really good in transition, too. They move up and down the ice really fast, do a great job of spreading the puck around in transition. Tough to defend.
Face off to the left of Pearson. Redhawks win in their own zone. Get a fire half wall. Clement will fire it up the right wing side of center ice. It's chipped into the zone there by Rigish. Near side with a puck is Ports. North Dakota in his zone end. Left it for Ness, who was hit hard by Rigish. Couldn't get the pass. Ports took it away. Over the Redhawk line right wing. Will spin it around the far boards. The far side, Fletcher. He let it go off his stick. North Dakota gets it there. Ports near circle. Ferner a shot. Nice save by Daske with the legs. Moore comes into the corner. The backhand play will go through the slot. And it's Fletcher chipping it forward to the middle of the ice for Ferner. North Dakota will regain control on their own end. Here is Ford, far side. Walks it up the boards through center ice. Over the Redhawk line, left wing with a shot. And Pearson right there with the glove save to steal it away with 6:33 to go in the first period. Another stoppage. And a draw coming to Ludwig's right.
And since that first North Dakota goal, it has been just about all Miami can do to get the puck down the ice and get a break for a change. Almost no time of possession for the Redhawks since that first North Dakota goal. Gonna have to work on that.
For real. North Dakota wins a draw to the right of Pearson. Puck deflects near half wall. Calder rips one in off Cullen's leg to the far side. Miami chips it to center ice. North Dakota with numbers there to regain control and regroup. Fired back in the Redhawks zone. Cullen picks it up behind the Miami net. Spins it near corner. Moulton trying to chip it up the boards. As Ford applied pressure, he'll find Cullen though to the far corner. will get out the lob wedge to get it to center ice. Picked up here by Cooper Moore for North Dakota. He'll try to get in the Miami zone. Collins stolen away and then tried to skate it through center. Moore picked him off over the Red Hawk line right wing. Calder will fire his shot. And guess what? Another save by Ludwig Pearson. And that is now his 12th save on 13 North Dakota shots tonight.
Yeah, they're really putting him through the paces tonight. But if anyone can handle it, it's Ludwig.
Yep. It has been all North Dakota in this game so far. Our entire period, we've been looking to our right where their goal is from our vantage point that they score on and where Pearson is. This game could be 4-0 right now, easy.
Sure could.
Face-off win for North Dakota to the left of Pearson. They tie up four in the near corner. Drazder ends up winning the battle for Miami, but has no help. He's one against two now in another battle that locks up against the boards, and North Dakota comes away in that one. Gamer sent it left point. It's ripped in softly there by Clevin. Blocker by Pearson to the far half wall. Redhawks trying to work it out on that right wing, but they can't. Nice job by Caulfield working all alone, one against three, to keep that puck in on a board battle. Finally squirts to the neutral zone where Clevin has it center circle. A backhand shovel into the zone behind Pearson's net. Ludwig will chip it far corner when pressure came in from UND. Caulfield ends up there with a puck, trying to work it up those far boards. We'll flip one right point. Chandrick a shot. Pat save Pearson in the near corner. Or Capstick with a backhand pass to Regish. Now it's near side Cassetti over the center ice red line left wing and over the Red Hawk line left wing as Chandrick there will strip him of the puck. And Miami in a change will retreat to the bench. Chandrick skates it through center ice over the Red Hawk line right wing. Stripped there by Matt Parmelini. Now it's Red Savage trying to chip it up the boards near side. It squirts through center ice to the far wing where Fritz picks it up for North Dakota in his own end. DD pass there for Jandrick. His cross-ice feed got picked off by Savage. Jandrick picked it up, sending over the Red Hawk line right wing. Back for Yonerick. And his shot got deflected off Clement's stick and back into the North Dakota zone where the Fighting Hawks will regroup here. Payne with it. Right side, center ice red line over the Red Hawk line right wing. Red Savage stripped him away from the puck. Let it go up for his brother Ryan. He's over the UND line left wing. Now Daschke got stripped. The D-man joined the rush. Here's Ports. One against two the other way. Into the Miami zone. Chips it far side. The give-and-go pass could not connect with Ness. Puck ends up near half-wall Miami end where it's sent back behind the Red Hawk cage for Moulton. Four to go in the first. 1-0 North Dakota. Daschke sends it up near side for Fletcher. He got stripped of the puck. Right point Miami zone and Ports there to rim it back around the boards behind the Miami net to the far corner. Moulton there with a puck for Red Savage. Near side Daschke in the corner. Red Hawks will work it out of their end as Fletcher at center ice turns the puck over near the penalty boxes. Finally it's regained control and the Red Hawks send it back behind the UND cage. Ferner clears it up the near wing boards, gets to Calder, 3-on-2 the other way, North Dakota. That's over the Red Hawk line left wing, back for Calder, far circle, a drive to the net. Good job by Murray to angle him away, did not get the angle. Down the near corner with the puck is Cullen for Miami. Finds Regish up the near wing boards, back to center ice. Cullen will scan it over the UND line left wing and get to the near circle with a puck, 3:10 to go first period. And he's stripped of it in that near circle. Calder works it out to center ice. And then it was locked up against the boards by Barry, who tried to send it back in, but an offside on Miami. Not everybody had gotten out of the zone yet. So, 3:05 to go, first period, 1-0 North Dakota, a timeout on the ice, and this is Miami Hockey on Red Hawk Radio. Five to go, first period. North Dakota 1, Miami nothing. Patrick Geshan, Jack Schmelzinger back of the air at Steve Cady Arena. Mitchell A. Sarai's coming up on the North Dakota right wing, closest to the Fighting Hawk blue line. Near side of the ice from our vantage point, and it's a clean win for North Dakota. In the faceoff circle, they've done very well in that tonight. Chipped ahead into the Miami zone, picked up there by Daskus, chips it out to center ice. It's Jandrick with it, back in his own end for North Dakota, finds a pass, Calder turn it over, middle of the ice though in the UND zone. Daskus lost it in his skates. Clevin picked it up, fires it far side for the Fighting Hawks. They're going to work it over the Red Hawk line, left wing. Ford gave it up in the circle, a weird shot there that went wide off the stick of Constantini. And the Red Hawks here will chip it off the far boards back to center ice. Pletsky with a puck over the UND line, right wing. Chandrick picked it up there, let it go behind the net. Daskus can't slide it ahead of the UND net. So now Corbett with it far corner in a battle trying to win the puck away. Here's Jandrick for Caulfield, near side. North Dakota works it out over the Red Hawk line, right wing, with 2:12 to go in the period. Caulfield behind the net, wraparound try on Pearson. He had the right pad there. And the Red Hawks work it up the right wing, but can't get it out initially from their zone. A little battle right in front of the Miami bench. Puck squirts out to neutral ice. Schmaltz is on it there for North Dakota, and then give it up. And here comes Sladek over the UND line, right wing. Put on a move, far circle, but lost the puck. Sanderson far corner with it behind the net. Works it to the near side for North Dakota. Up the right wing for Caulfield. He's going to come over the Red Hawk line right wing. Chip it up to the near corner. Daskey let it go for Schmaltz. And now far side Gaber. Back to the left point, Sanderson. North Dakota offensive zone. Frisch right point. Slid it across. Looking for a one-timer there that did not really connect with Gaber. It's locked up behind the Miami net. Gaber comes away with the puck. Let it go for Senden. Far corner. He'll walk it up the far board. Spin it around to the area behind the net, where Graham will lock up Yonernick against the boards, and the Red Hawks will finally chip it out to center ice off the stick of John Sladek. North Dakota trying to catch Miami to change. Yonernick over the Red Hawk line right away for Senden. Could not connect to him in front of the net. Puck goes to the near corner, where it's Senden working it up the near wing boards. A pass to the middle, picked off with a minute to go in the period. Here's Moulton, center circle, dumps it into the near corner of the North Dakota zone. Goes far corner more. And he will try to flip it far side. Yonernick couldn't get control of that pass. So it's back in the Miami end, picked up by Red Savage in a North Dakota change. Will Cullen, near side Miami zone, trying to chip it middle of the ice. He will do so. Barbellini over the UND line, left wing, with a break to the net. Near circle, a shot. Nice chest save is made there by Driscoll in the net. That's the first one he's had to make in a while. 27 left, first period. Calder over the Red Hawk line, left wing with Ford. Chips it up to the far corner. He will get in a battle there with Red Savage. Yonernick back to the left point. Win the puck there for North Dakota. Ferner. Middle blue line, Constantini ripped it over the net. Off the high glass, Moore sends a weird wrister wide right in the net from the left point with 5 to go in the period. Here's Calder, middle of the ice, Constantini. That pass didn't work. Now it's back to center. And Moore will just dump it in down the right wing boards as time expires in the first. North Dakota 1, Miami nothing after 20, and the shots on goal, 14-3, Fighting Hawks. That's the story.
Yeah, Patrick, there's not much good to say from the Red Hawks' perspective about this game so far, other than the fact that you are still in this game. It hasn't been pretty. It feels like they're out of it a little bit. It feels like more than a one-goal lead for North Dakota, at least to me.
Yeah.
But they are still in the game, and all it takes is one bounce, one good play, and they will be tied. Couple more, you never know what could happen.
And if you don't have Ludwig Pearson in your net, this is a 5-0 game right now, you could say.
Absolutely, and it's not just that he's making a lot of saves, he's making excellent saves. Yep. On really high danger chances from North Dakota. A really, really good start for the Swedish goaltender, and what else would you expect at this point?
I mean, yeah, that's true, and a lot of people are coming here to start to watch Ludwig Pearson, scouts and of that sort. A lot of people coming to the area this weekend, scouts and such that we saw downstairs before the game, and they were asking about number 32 in Ludwig Pearson. They're very impressed by him, and this kid will get picked up at some point or another by a pro team. There's no question about that. 14-3 are the shots. Like I mentioned, it seemed like, though, the energy just wasn't there for Miami. Obviously, you kill three penalties, you know, in that period. You want to not have that, of course, not going into the box at all, but that probably sucked out some energy from this team, and they've just got to find some energy here. You're on your home ice, you got a full crowd watching you. what else do you want?
Yeah, and for the first 5 minutes or so, it felt like Miami was all over the ice. It felt like North Dakota was moving a little bit slow, maybe a little jet-lagged. With about 15 minutes remaining in the period, that changed big time.
Yeah.
And I think that's a good point you made. Those three penalties that Miami had to kill, that is pretty demoralizing. Every time you break out of that penalty kill, having another one come up, it's got to be tough mentally for the RedHawks.
Right. So we will see how they overcome that. Here are some numbers after our first period of play. We mentioned the shots, 14-3 in favor of North Dakota. Those are the shots on goal, the shots period, no matter if they hit the net or not. North Dakota 30, Miami 7.
Wow.
Power play, North Dakota was 1-for-3. That's how they scored their goal to take the 1-0 lead in this game. Miami is 0-for-1 on the man advantage. Face-off wins led by North Dakota 11-6. Miami 8 blocked shots to North Dakota's 2. And the penalty minutes column is led by Miami 6-2 in the hockey game. Our scoring summary here tonight, Reese Gaber had the goal for North Dakota. It was on the power play, came 11:24 into that first period. They give the assist to both Jake Sanderson and Jake Schmaltz. So that's how North Dakota got the goal, as Reese Gaber picked up his 5th of the year in that department. About a 14-minute break or so before our first period of action, or our second period of action rather, will commence. 1-0 North Dakota leads Miami here after 20 minutes. Join us in about 14 minutes or so for period 2 action here. You are listening to Miami Hockey on Red Hawk Radio, our first intermission. Patrick Etch and Jack Schmelzinger back with you here for period number two. Miami and North Dakota on the ice. 1-0 Fighting Hawks lead this game so far after a first period, Jack, that was dominated by North Dakota. For those just joining us, the shots on goal were in favor of the Fighting Hawks, 14-3.
Yeah, and Miami is, there's just no ifs, ands, or buts about it. Miami is going to have to come out playing a little bit harder and a little bit better this period if they want to hang in this game. Like we said at the end of last period, this game could have been 4 or 5-0 if Ludwig Pearson hadn't had such a good period. Well, the game could be 4 or 5-0 pretty quick here, too.
Right. RedHawks move left to right across your radio here in period number two. There's an offside call here, and again, it's going right after the center ice draw on North Dakota. A little bit of movement on the right side of the zone. That comes 7 seconds into our second period. Yeah, Pearson had 13 saves on 14 North Dakota shots on goal in that first period. Draw coming here on the Miami left wing, closest to their blue line. Far side of the ice in the neutral zone. North Dakota loses this draw. Here's Clement up the right wing side. We'll dump it in from the center ice red line around behind the North Dakota net. Far half wall, Barbellini. We'll play it near corner for Sanderson. We'll hit Gavin Hain with a pass through center ice. That play broken up by Barbellini. Left side of the center ice red line. He'll dump it in around the boards in the North Dakota zone. It squirts out to center. Hain will take it over the Red Hawk line left wing, but he was stripped by Red Savage, who put some dangles together right at the line. And then Hain will grab it here, far circle, and a turnover, and send it near half wall in the Miami zone for Sanderson. Back to the line for Hain. A spin around shot goes off the body of Red Savage, sent up the wall back into North Dakota zone, and Sanderson has it near circle. Plays it up the left wing for Schmaltz over the Red Hawk line left wing. A little rush, far side, a wide open shot, and a save there by Pearson on Caulfield. Here's Jandrick, right point down the boards. Sent it back for Gaber. Spins his way to the middle. Schmaltz, far circle, a shot that goes off his stick, up and out of play, with 1:10 gone by in the second period. Draw to the left of Pearson. And the game led by North Dakota 1-0. Just the second home game of the year for Miami, as they started the season out playing just one home game out of their first eight. Draws won by North Dakota. Jandrick takes it behind the net to the near corner. We'll pass it left post for Schmaltz. He was spun off the puck, though, by Rigas behind the net, and Rigas will spin it around the boards to the left point. Clevin on it here, walks it down the near wing boards in a circle. We'll center a weak one in front off a skate, then it emerges on the stick of Fletcher. Red Hawks escape the zone. Here's Rigas over the Red Hawk, the UND line left wing, rather. Berry hits the brakes. Far corner, gave it back for Capstick. Slides it right point to Rasser. Back down low below the goal line, and here comes Rigas with a puck up the far half wall for North Dakota, for Miami against North Dakota, but then North Dakota steals it away. Here's Berry near corner. On the puck there for Miami, Caulfield is shoved over. Corbett trips up with him as well. Jandrick kicked it free in front, a save there off the body of the goaltender Driscoll. Clement right point, Miami offensive zone, a play in front and went off the backhand of Berry and tipped up into the chest of Driscoll. He'll make a stop, and that will stop the clock with 17:53 to go in the second.
Well, Miami just almost doubled their shot total there in that about 20 seconds.
I was just gonna say
that. So that's
that.
A good thing, I guess.
Yeah. 15-5 now are the shots in favor of North Dakota. Draw to the left of Driscoll. First time we said that tonight, seems like. Corbett here near corner, Miami in the offensive zone, locked up there with a couple of Fighting Hawks. Puck squirts the far corner. Calder will spin it around to the near side for Brady Ferner. Near half wall, he'll chip it out. Back to the neutral zone. Ford over the Red Hawk line. Left wing break to the net. And then he had a cross-ice pass over for Calder on the right post, but could not make contact with it. He was on the right post back door, and if he would have maybe got a stick on it, could have been a 2-0 game as Pearson didn't really slide over in time. Calder with it near half wall. North Dakota offensive zone. Ford back to the line for more. Slides it right point. Ferner down low behind the net. Went past Pearson. Here's Moore with it again in the near corner. Ferdaski chips it up the boards near side. Back in the zone with a puck left point is Ness. Spins it around the boards to the far side. Constantini Let it go there for Will Cullen behind that net, and that puck squirts out in front of Ludwig Pearson, who makes the cover. 16:55 to go in the second. Student retention rate after the first period is 100%.
Yeah, not bad at all. I was expecting to see a few more empty seats than we're seeing, really. Still filled up. The Red Hawk fans, large attention spans tonight.
It's only 8 o'clock, too.
Yeah, right. Huh. Got a little more time to kill.
Throw to the left here of Pearson. Ness in the circle with Cassetti. Up far corner, Moulton picks it up, slides it out to center ice. North Dakota on it here through the circle. When the puck is Ports over the line, left wing in the Miami zone. Gave it up there in the corner for Ness. Here's Ports. Up that near half wall with Skata to the line. He's kind of taking a tour of the attacking zone here for North Dakota as Cullen rode him all the way. That shot went off the right post on the ice. Rebound picked up by Pletsky. Over the UND line, left wing, chips it far corner. Behind the net, Sanderson. Trying to pick it up here, but gave it up for Ness. Who skates it up the near side for North Dakota. Chips it out to center ice. And it's back in the center ice circle. Red Hawks will regroup here with a play to get it up the ice. Here's Pletsky over the line, left wing. Trying to backhand pass to Daskus. And that will cause the play to go offside as the puck exited the zone on the play.
Patrick, I think both of us probably heard pretty early on in our youth hockey careers, don't mess around with the puck when you're skating at the blue line, because that is a ticket to an easy offside.
Yes, sir. I heard hockey games are decided on the blue lines. It's kind of true. Pass up ahead, Hayne with it toward the net for North Dakota. Nice pat save by Pearson to meet him there. Hayne really didn't have a clean chance. Barbellini far corner, slides it up. Ryan Savage kind of blowing up high in the Miami zone, able to get the puck though to Barbellini. Over the line right away, he will fire a shot off the near corner as it deflected off his stick in front. Puck picked up there by Clevin of North Dakota in a battle with Barbellini. Squirts up to the left point for Capstick. Slides to the right point, cross ice to Rasner. Capstick, center blue line. Watts it near side, his shot off a stick. Goes to the far corner, Clevin picks it up, trying to rim it up, but can't. Is coming in for a big hit on him was Ryan Savage trying to get some revenge. North Dakota works it out up the left wing. Hayne dumps it in, center ice red line behind the net. Clement was on it. Far corner, Daskey will skate it up and out. Fired ahead for Fletcher. He will chip it over to Ryan Savage. Over the UND line right wing, Caulfield will emerge with it here. Tip it down low for Ferner behind the goal line in North Dakota zone. Moore fires it up near side for Gaber. Over the line on the left wing in the Miami zone. He'll be locked up there in the circle along with Regish. They tie up for it in the corner. As Daskey and Regish lock up against the boards with a couple fighting Hawks. Battle won by North Dakota. Right point with a puck. Far side, Ferner got it to the far corner. Gaber on it here, skates it up the far wing board, spins around at the right point, and will shoot this one toward the net. Went off a stick behind the cage. Up the near side with it for Miami. That is Barry. And will give it up at center ice back to the Fighting Hawks. 14:28 to go in the second. 1-0 North Dakota on top. Puck far half wall, Miami zone, chip to center ice. Club down there by Moore. He will spin this one around the board to the near side, where it's grabbed by Clement, who will lift it out to center ice. Club down by Sanderson. He will send an errant pass through the center circle. Picked up though by Constantini. Back to Sanderson in his own zone, and now middle of the ice with it is Frisch. Calder far side. Over the Red Hawk line right away. Calder with a little break to the net. Far circle shot. And a nice pad save by Pearson. Ludwig comes up with it. And that stops the clock with 13:59 to go in the second period. North Dakota 1, Miami nothing. We are back in a moment to Steve Cady Arena. You are listening to Miami Hockey on Red Hawk Radio. 13:59 to go. Second period. Trot coming up to the left of Ludwig Pearson in the Red Hawk net. Far side of the ice in the North Dakota offensive zone. Patrick Geshan, Jack Schmelzinger back with you here on Red Hawk Radio tonight. False start on this draw that features Constantini for North Dakota against Miami's Monty Graham.
Battle of the 18s.
Yep.
Which 18 is better?
Monty Graham.
Let's go.
Behind the net, face-off win for Cullen. Fires it up the near wing boards back to center ice. Corbett trying to chip it over the UND line right wing. Did get it past Sanderson, and it's in the far half wall now of the UND zone. Here's Gramps. Fires it back to give and go with Moulton in the Red Hawk end. Fires it right side. Sladek chips it over the UND line right wing. Sanderson on it here behind the net. And he will take it far side, chip it up for Calder. Buck Swartz back far circle North Dakota zone. Frisch will get it behind the cage again for Sanderson. On the left wing, pass to the middle. It is picked off by Cullen. Daskus takes it over, and he's over the UND line right wing in the near corner. Daskus trying to slide it past Frisch. That did not work. Bodies collide here near side of the North Dakota zone, and Cullen will break up a play here. The Constantini had trying to get it out. Daskus near corner, centering pass that didn't hit anybody. You're at the right point, Cassetti. We'll give it right to the Fighting Hawks, and they're going to come up the ice with it. Constantini over the Miami line. Left wing will dump it in the near corner and back behind the net. Moulton on it here will spin it off the boards and up to the left point where it goes out of the zone to center ice. Seems like in this game, nobody really gets possession of the puck. They just give it back to each other.
Yeah, it's a bunch of dump-ins from both teams.
It's weird. Near corner with a puck for North Dakota. Clement to the line. Goes far side and with it. That's Jandrick. His rip wide of the net for the far circle. Here in the near half wall and up the ice with it comes Daskus. Over the line right wing, Cassetti tried to play it middle. Jandrick took it over there. Broke up a nice two-on-one opportunity and North Dakota starts the rush north the other way. Here's Ness over the Red Hawk line right wing to the circle. In front, a tip there by Coons. That hit the side of the net to Twine. Just a bad angle. Far side, Clevin, a bomb to the right point. That's a pad save, Pearson, through traffic. It deflects to center ice. Here's a little break. Cassetti over the line left wing. Cuts far circle, a shot. And a great save made by Driscoll as he got the wrister up high in his chest and able to make the cover as it hit the ice. 11:59 to go in the second period, and the clock has stopped.
These North Dakota guys have some serious shots, don't they?
It's like they just do that all day long. Just
probably
shoot
do.
Pucks.
Yeah, really. Not much else to do up there, I guess.
No, there's not. It's like these guys are just more skilled, stronger, faster. They just, those little things.
I think those are some pretty big things, Patrick.
Yep. Here comes North Dakota in the offensive zone. Hain over the Red Hawk line left wing. We'll take it to the corner. Give it up there for Yonernick. In the circle, Red Savage collides with a body. Here comes Ryan Savage out through center ice. Center ice red line right wing. Chips it into the North Dakota zone. It goes behind the net. Frisch first to it. Rims it around the boards far side. Sendin gets it out. Right wing Yonner, cross-ice feed, looking for Hain left wing. That went off the stick of Murray, and the play kind of broken, and it's offside on North Dakota. So they had men coming in the zone down the right wing. The cross-ice feed went off Murray's stick as the puck was skated in over the left wing side by Hain. Offside with 11:27 to go in the second.
I'll be interested to hear what you think about this, Patrick. Maybe a little bit of a renewed effort from the Hawks so far in the period. Nothing crazy, but it looks like they're moving a little bit faster.
I would agree. North Dakota with the puck in their own zone after the neutral ice draw. Schmaltz with it, skates it over the line right wing in the Miami zone. And you'll find this one in the corner. Schmaltz tripped up though by a hole. There's got to be a hole down there in the Zamboni doors. Everybody tripping on it. Red Hawks over the line left wing. Regish trying to go for Fletcher in the circle. Barry ends up with a puck and roofs it wide right of the net. Clement right point. Fires it back below the goal line behind the net to North Dakota net. Ringish there for Miami. Trying to skate it to the near corner. He'll go up the half wall and spin around in the circle. Takes it behind the net for Fletcher. Far corner, back to the line, Daskey. Right point, Clement. Back for Daskey again. Far circle, Fletcher. The shot, really weak one there. A pad save was made by Driscoll. Near half wall, Clement will try to slide it down. Caulfield on it here for North Dakota. We get a whistle for a penalty interference. We call it, I believe, on North Dakota. I guess in a corner battle there, they got number 4 in green. That's Cooper Moore, the Red Wing draft pick. And Miami back to the power play for the second time tonight on the interference, Minor to Moore.
And like we said earlier in the game, this North Dakota penalty kill, middle of the pack nationally, a chance for the RedHawks to capitalize here, maybe tie this one up.
Power play tonight has been 0 for 1 for the RedHawks. Their second try, there's a shot that went off the left post from the line by Moulton. Back to the right point, Cullen. Near circle, Savage, his shot, pat save made by the goaltender Driscoll. It's 1-0 North Dakota, 10:15 to go in the second. Another shot to the line, deflects wide of the net. Behind the net, Daskis can't steal it away from Miami. Clement took it from him. Cullen keeps it in right point and gave it up for Clement at the half wall, and he'll spin it all the way back behind the Miami net for the clear. 1:27 left in the power play. Moulton for Cullen. Through center ice over the UND line right away. Cullen cuts to the slot. Left point with it. Moulton slides it to the far half wall. North Dakota will clear from there. Off of Miami shin guard. I think that was Cassetti. It deflected off of back in his own end. So here's Barry. Skates it out for the RedHawks. We'll chip it over the line on the right wing. Spin it around the boards to the far half wall. Caulfield gives it up. Clement will get it right back to Barry. Near side on a turnover for North Dakota. Right point, Daskey with a puck. 54 to go on the Miami power play. RedHawks trail by one. Here's Regish. Far half wall. Spins it in front for Savage. That was Ryan Savage who gave it up. Back to the line it goes for Daskey. Far circle with it is Regish. Skates it up toward the left point, looking for a lane to shoot it. Daskey at the line, a blast. It was deflected down in traffic, hit Sanderson's body in front, and sent back to center ice. Over the line, left wing with the puck is Barmelini. In the circle, finds Barry, open room to shoot, and he fired it wide to the left post. Daskey back at the line with a puck. Barry near half wall with 20 left in the power play. Daskey, high slot. Far circle with the puck, Regis back for Daskey. Waits, shoots! That went off the pad in front of Driscoll. Barry centers it in front. Ryan Savage wasn't ready. Puck in the far circle, they get it back in front, loose in the crease, and covered up by Driscoll as it deflected in on him. And a shove there late as Matt Barry came in late to the play after it was covered by Driscoll. He gets a nice friendly shove from Judd Caulfield. Crowd loves that. They will have no penalties coming up. Three to go on the power play for Miami, and that's the best the offense for the RedHawks has looked all night long.
And I might go as far as saying that might be the best that the offense has looked all season. That was a really impressive minute, 57 seconds on the power play. Probably, I don't know, six or seven shots on net, two or three really, really high danger chances. A great power play for Miami. They still got 3 seconds left. Maybe they can do something with that.
They win the draw to the left of Driscoll. Capstick a rip from the right point on the wrister. Driscoll has it in the red basket. And it'll stop play here with 8:29 to go in the second as the power play expires. Moore is out of the box. And we will get a stoppage here. Again, 8:29 to go in the second period. North Dakota 1, Miami nothing. RedHawks can't convert on the power play chance. And this is Miami Hockey on RedHawk Radio. .29 to go in our second period. 1-0 North Dakota over Miami. Offensive zone draw coming up for the RedHawks. Patrick Geshan, Jack Schmelzinger back with you here at Steve Cady Arena. The draw is won by North Dakota. They'll work it up the far half wall and out of the zone. Caulfield with it. We'll get it over the line. Here's Calder through the far circle. Never had an angle to shoot it at the net. And we'll get it up the boards to Sanderson, left point. His blast off Sladek's stick, high out of play with 8:13 to go in the second period.
I don't know if you've noticed Jake Sanderson tonight, Patrick, but you can really tell why the Ottawa Senators made him a first-round pick a couple of years ago. Just such a great skater, a great stick handler, yep. Really skilled, and obviously high hockey IQ. He's a sophomore, and he's already quarterbacking that UND power play. I'm pretty sure he was doing it last year as a freshman, too. Just a great all-around player, Jake Sanderson, for the Fighting Hawks.
He's out of Whitefish, Montana, played before North Dakota at the U.S. Under-18 team. Yeah, he's going to have a long pro career, that's for sure. Puck here in the Miami zone near half wall. Spun around behind the net for Pearson. Terrasser, the only one back for Miami to get it. Capstick now with a puck. Spins it through the circle for Daskus and up the near wing boards. Pletsky, turn over to him. Here's Ports. Leaves it for Ness. Down in the corner, spins it around the boards to the far half wall. Do it. There is Ferner. Back behind the net. Grabbing it is Ness. He will get in a battle there with Capstick far side. Now with it is Daskus, locked up against the boards with his stick. Port spins it up, Cassetti with it, the backhand play through center ice, all the way down the ice. As Moore grabs it here for North Dakota in the near circle. Off the boards for Koontz. Fires it over on the far side, Ports chips it ahead. Down to the far corner, Clement on the puck here for Miami. Rims it around to the near corner for Drazner. Robbie Drazner will spin it up to the near side for Ryan Savage through center ice. And Cassetti over on the far side of center ice, can't get it down deep in the North Dakota zone. Now we get a whistle here as the puck was bouncing around the neutral zone. Is that a hand pass?
Maybe a high stick, I'm really not sure.
All right. Puck was like a billiard ball going around neutral ice there. It's like watching a tennis match sometimes in this game tonight.
It really has. A lot of, not a lot of breakout passes, it's a lot
weird.
More breakout chips.
Yeah. Gerard neutral ice, Miami left wing closest to their blue line, one back North Dakota. Jandrick, center ice, red line, right wing, will spin it around the boards behind the Miami net. Strong North Dakota, forecheck, they had a shot off. Caulfield in front, big rebound. Everything saved by Pearson. As Barbellini skates into safety at center ice for Miami. Jandrick with a puck in his own end, far side, the pass for Schmaltz. In over the line right away, Caulfield trying to chip it over. That play was broken up by Brent Golick, the linesman. Back to the near side here for Clement. In the Miami zone, room to work with up for Red Savage. Chips it over the UND line right wing into their zone. Gamer near half wall with a puck, fires it off the glass, back to center ice. Daskey with it, far side for Cullen, the backhand play for Red Savage. Left wing over the UND line. He will let this thing go to the far half wall, send and pin Savage up against the boards. That's Red Savage. Now it's loose far circle. UND works it on their own end, back through center ice. Ends up on the stick of Moulton. And back in the Miami end here, Cullen goes D to D, Moulton left wing, cross ice feed, right wing with it, Barry over the UND line. Will fire a shot purposely wide of the net off the end boards. It spins out of play after a North Dakota clearing attempt went off of a Miami skate and over the glass. 5:57 left in the second, 1-0 North Dakota over Miami. The Fighting Hawks lead the shots 21-10.
This one's moving pretty ridiculously fast, I would say, Patrick. I feel like there's hardly any stoppages in play.
It is.
Like a tennis match, like you've been saying. Back and forth, back and forth.
All right. Draw to the left here of Driscoll. Redhawks win it, keep it in the offensive zone. Forward behind the net to the far half wall. With it there is Ashton Calder. Gave it up for Barry. Now Rigas pins up forward against the boards. Constantini got in there as well. Rigas down the far half wall, spins it in front. A puck that deflected wide of the stick of Fletcher. Up the near wing boards, Constantini from North Dakota gets it out to center ice. Redhawks regroup it though near side in front of the penalty boxes. Spin it back in the North Dakota zone. Sanderson far corner for Frisch. Up the right wing with a puck comes North Dakota. Here's Ford, a little rush the other way. Over the Redhawk line, left wing, far circle. Calder came in, near side. Sanderson, a wide open net to shoot at, and he scores. For some reason, Pearson was out of the blue paint, flailing in the slot. When that puck deflected the near circle, and Jake Sanderson had a wide open 6x4 to fire it in. And he did so. I think Pearson just fell. Flat out fell.
Yeah, I totally agree. Looks like he just maybe caught a divot in the ice.
Something.
But he was on his hands and knees with the goal pretty wide open behind him, and that puck just floated right out to Sanderson's stick, and a player that good is not going to make a mistake on that one.
And Pearson was out of the blue paint, too. He was out of the crease. The foul made him fall forward and out of the blue paint, so it's 2-0 North Dakota with 5:05 to go here in the second period. Here's Moore near circle, spins it up the wall. On the near side of center ice, Drasner is on it for Miami. Ness and Coons will battle with him. Bonnie Graham is on it there in the battle right in front of the penalty box. Redhawks working free here to the middle of the ice. Capstick for Drasner. Up the wing right side for Graham. Chips it in the near circle, North Dakota zone. Ferner is on it here. Off the boards, up the ice. Here comes Ness over the line left wing through the circle. He will spin it behind Pearson here to the far side. Ness was on it for a moment, then kind of left it there in the far corner. Clement and Ports crashing on the battle. North Dakota wins, and they get a shot from the right point that came off the stick of Ferner. Goes behind the net. Spun near circle. Moore a blast. That goes high off the glass. Far half wall of the puck. That's Gaber. Rims it around the boards to the near half wall for Moore. North Dakota offensive zone still with 4:10 to go in the second. Back up high. Clevin wide open shot. Deflects off Pearson's glove. Loose in the slot. Clement picks it up. And he will spin this one around to the far side in the corner. Still in the offensive zone, North Dakota. Schmaltz comes in with a shot. Turned on the Jets to the far circle, and Pearson has the pad save. And a crucial cover. The Redhawks are going to need this media timeout. They were very tired. About a two-minute shift there for all five guys that were on the ice. 3:55 to go, second period. 2-0 North Dakota. They take the lead, double the lead, I should say, on the Sanderson goal, and we're back in a moment. This is Miami Hockey on Red Hawk Radio. .55 to go, second period. 2-0 North Dakota over Miami here at Steve Cady Arena. Draw coming up to the left of Ludwig Pearson. And is Schmaltz in it with Cassetti. And a clean win back for Cassetti here as Daskey will get it behind the red hot cage for Jack Clement. North Dakota, the two-goal lead after Sanderson scored a few minutes ago in the period. This is an icing call on the Redhawks. That's the first icing we've had tonight.
I was just thinking the exact same thing.
3:46 to go in the second. That North Dakota goal scored 14:45 into the second period. Jake Sanderson had it. The assist to Ashton Calder and Connor Ford. And for Sanderson, that's his fourth of the year. In terms of goals, North Dakota wins his draw in the offensive zone near corner. Schmaltz had the puck, gave it up for Daskey. We'll run it around the boards to the far side. Poletsky gave it up there. Caulfield sent it back in his zone. Redhawks quickly work it out. And in his own end with a Jandrick for North Dakota. Clement, near side pass, center ice. Caulfield a rink wide to the right point, right side rather, for Gaber who tried to enter the Miami zone but couldn't. He was spun back. And will finally skate cross ice to the neutral zone and dump it in left point behind the Redhawk net. Clement around the boards off Cassetti's stick, trying to go for the breakout pass. It missed it, kind of. Another icing on Miami here with 3:06 to go in the second. I'm interested what the student retention rate is going to be after 40 minutes.
That is a great question, especially that second North Dakota goal might make a little bit of a difference.
Yeah.
Redhawks really want to keep people in the crowd. They'll score another one before, or score
right?
One, that is, before the end of this period.
They really haven't had a whole lot to cheer about tonight.
Nope. A few close chances.
Yep. Puck went back to the right point. Frisch wins into North Dakota offensive zone, goes behind the net. Yonerick on it there, back to the far half wall. Frisch for Yonerick. Daskis kind of tied him off. Puck was loose in the far circle. Sennett escapes with it here. Clement trying to glove it down. He does. Puck squirts the far corner. Daskis on it here. And we'll work it up the boards. I think he's trying to pass to Clement there in the far corner, but Haynes stole it away. Clement didn't react. So it's Cassetti with it. Miami zone near side through the circle. Room to skate. He'll whack it off the boards back to the North Dakota zone, and Sanderson picks it up. Full five-man long second period change for Miami. Fighting Hawks over the Red Hawk line left wing. Sennett in the corner. Looking for a room to the net. Finds a man up at the left point. That was Sanderson. He had to pick up the pass off the boards. Through the circle, cannot spin it down low. Now Hayne will get it to Sanderson here in the near corner. Brett Savage pins him up against the boards. A little battle ensues. Sanderson, though, using those speed and footwork skills to work it up to the left point. He skated it himself. Far side, Frisch, wide open lane to shoot. Fired it wide left on the ice of Pearson. Hayne back down to the corner. With it here is Calder. Skates it up the wing. There's a blast by Clevin that deflected off his stick. Got a fan on the shot. Red Savage, trouble getting it out in the circle. He cannot. And now Calder back for Clevin. Left point for North Dakota. Spins it around the boards and in behind the net. Calder for Ford, near side of the ice. Clevin brings it down the boards. Ford here in the near circle. Deflected off Moulton. Skates. Sent to center ice. Jandrick on it will wind up and blast it around the boards to the near half wall here for North Dakota. Cullen there, spins it behind the net. Moulton with 1:23 to go in the second. 2-0 North Dakota. This puck is worked back to center ice. Ryan Savage, left side up, center ice, gave it up. North Dakota sends it right back below the goal line in the Miami zone. Moulton around the boards near side for Ryan Savage. Flips it up to the near corner. Regis on it there, cannot feed it in front for Yandrick. Here's Barry back to the near side. Right point, Drasner will club it into the North Dakota zone. Here's Barry with a puck. As he was hit by Regis there in the corner, and now all of a sudden a 2-on-3 battle ensues. Ness spins it around the boards to the left point. Capstick on it here with 45 to go in the second. Fletcher, far circle. Gives it up there for Barry, rims it around the boards left point. Fletcher to Drasner, right point in front. They chipped it to Fletcher, tried to go for the backdoor right post pass, and took a deflection off Fletcher's stick and went 30 feet in the air. 36.1 to go in the second, out of play.
Yeah, great idea there from Robbie Drasner and PJ Fletcher. Just not great execution. That one a little bit way too high of an angle, actually. That one was all the way up into the netting.
We're not geography. Geometry.
I was just going to say, yeah. We got to get some math majors on the hockey team.
Geometry,
soon.
Geography, geology.
We're not any of those, no. For sure.
30 seconds left in the second period. Puck here in the near corner, North Dakota zone. They're going to work it out up the right side with room. Here comes a pass cross ice. Miss Ford's stick goes behind the net. In the Miami zone, North Dakota, great forecheck here to work to apply pressure. Daskey ends up with a puck, far corner. The pass to the near circle here for Clement with 8 to go in the second period. Chips it off glass, back to Sanderson, center ice area. Trying to go over the line left wing, he does. Through the circle, Sanderson rips it over Pearson. A very last second chance there to win the second period. North Dakota 2, Miami nothing after 40. The shots in favor of UND, 25-10 in the game. Well, you're still in it if you're Miami, but the shots on goal tell a good story, the scoreboard tells a good story, and they got to dig really deep here if they want to have any shot at winning this one.
Yeah, they really do, and I think that there's two things Miami needs to have happen in the third period for them to have a chance of winning this game, or even tying it up, getting a point here, which is so crucial in NCHC play. They need Ludwig Pearson to stay excellent in net, and I think they need to hope that they get a few bounces.
Yep.
Because they are not putting up much offensively at all consistently, and unless that's going to change, they're going to have to get lucky a couple times to get this one tied up.
I think so. Luck is going to be an important word for North Dakota. The way that they played, I feel like we still haven't seen the best, though, of North Dakota. I mean, what is your thoughts on that? I feel like they were a little sleepy-ish there in the second period, but based on how talented this team is, that doesn't look like it's that sleepy.
Right. Yeah, they did. I agree. I think that they looked a little bit sleepier than you would expect them to look. They still looked great. They still looked fast and like a really good hockey team, but I agree. I think that there's a little bit more in the tank here for North Dakota, which has to scare those Miami coaches behind the bench just a little bit. Be interesting to see what we see tomorrow from them after having a little bit more time under their belts in Oxford, a little bit more distance between them and that plane.
Yeah, it should be interesting to see, but we still got 20 minutes left tonight. North Dakota 2, Miami nothing. Here are your stats after 40 minutes. Mention the shots on goal. North Dakota 25, Miami 10 in that department. The overall shots, 49-20 now. North Dakota leads that. Redhawks are 0-for-2 on the power play tonight. North Dakota remains 1-for-3. All three of their chances came in that first period for the Fighting Hawks. Faceoffs are fairly even. That's led by North Dakota 20-17. Miami 9 block shots to North Dakota's 4. And the penalty minute department is led by Miami 6-4. They got a competition going on now where they blindfold somebody and they got to find a prize that's on the ice, and the crowd tells them via noise where to go pick it up. That's pretty funny.
Almost seems a little inhumane.
Yeah,
but
it is. I don't know what the prize, what's the prize?
Hopefully something at least decent. Kind of looks like a deflated balloon from up here. I hope that's not actually what it is.
Maybe. All right, about a 12 and a half, 13 minute break or so, and then we're back with you for third period action between Miami and North Dakota here at game one of the series. 2-0 North Dakota after 40. We're back with a third period momentarily. Stay with us. This is Miami Hockey on Red Hawk Radio. Third period about to get started here from Oxford, Ohio. Patrick Geshan, Jack Schmelzinger back in the high above the ice. Steve Cady Arena in Oxford. 2-0 North Dakota with the lead in this game so far. And they lead the shots 25-10. Critical period for Miami here is they got the split last weekend in Omaha. Trying to have some success this weekend on their home ice against the Fighting Hawks. RedHawks move right to left across your radio here in our third period. So Ludwig Pearson is to our right. Miami wins the center ice draw to get the third going. Ryan Savage, the chip, far side red line at center ice, back behind the North Dakota net. Far corner Sanderson works it up right point for Clement. And he will fire it into traffic there in the circle. It comes back to the center ice area and send it over the Red Hawk line right away. The back end play right in on Pearson. He will stop it. And that comes 19 seconds into our third period.
Pretty good crowd retention rate, I would say, Patrick, yes, here for the third. Pretty impressive, actually. I'm almost surprised.
2-0 game. It's not that far out of grasp.
That's right. Maybe these people aren't paying close enough attention to realize that it should be a lot more than 2-0 right now.
See a lot of phones. That are
sure do.
Draw on the left of Pearson here. Red Savage wins it for Miami. Here comes Barbellini up the ice. Fires it through the circle. Red Savage returns Barbellini over the North Dakota line right wing, but he was stripped of the puck in the circle by Caulfield, the far circle. RedHawks will turn it over. Ryan Savage, a shot wide right of the net. Barbellini near corner for Sanderson behind the cage. Works it near side for Frisch. Ryan Savage will spin it off a body back to center ice. Cullen there to pick it up for the Red Hawks in his own end. Cross ice feed, nice look to Barbellini over the North Dakota line, left wing. He'll get it here at the half wall and let it go down low for Red Savage. Back to the line they go for Moulton, the left point shot, and a great glove save there by Driscoll. Flash of leather, 59 seconds gone by in our third period.
I like that shot there from Dylan Moulton. Like we were saying at the end of last period, for the Red Hawks to really Gavin, have much of a chance in this game, they're going to need a couple or a few bounces to go their way. Well, one way to create luck for yourself, put the puck on net. Good things will happen eventually.
Right. Draw to the right of Driscoll. Ringus in at four Miami against North Dakota's Connor Ford. So one back to the near half wall here where a little battle ensues. Jandrick emerges with a puck, gets it behind the net for Clement. He will take it up the left wing of the North Dakota zone. Cross ice feed, Calder over the line right side. Trying to chip it forward, couldn't. Back at center ice is the puck. Levin roofs it back below the goal line around to the near wing. Moulton can't chip it out of the zone. He was trying to do so from the half wall back to the right point. Jandrick wide right on the ice toward the net. Levin far half wall came in with a shot. Pearson the pad save. Back to the right point it goes. Jandrick slides to the left point. Shot in Clevin. That's another pad save. Pearson, small rebound in front of him, is sent out to center ice by the Redhawks all the way down the ice. No icing the Zale. Must have gone off a stick or something. Ness right wing feed through center. Picked off by Capstick. Tips it over the blue line here to the North Dakota zone. Calder now with it for North Dakota. Over the Fighting Hawk from the Redhawk line right wing for Coons. Returns to Calder in the slot. He never really got clean control of the puck as it went through that circle, and here comes Miami back the other way. Butzke will skate over the UND line, middle of the ice. Rimming around the boards there behind the net to the far corner. With it is Drasner. Gonna lost it there in his skates with Coons. Now Moore with the puck here behind the net. Spins it up to the near wing side for North Dakota to get it out of their zone and back to center. Capstick crosses ice TD with Drasner in his own end. Returns to Capstick. Will skate it through center ice. Left wing feed Plutzky over the UND line. He got hit hard up high and it turns the puck over. Here's Ports over the line on the right wing for North Dakota in the Miami zone. We'll take it behind the net, wait for his men to change. Coming in there for a one-time chance, it was fanned on in the slot was Hain. Went to the near corner. Jandrick had the puck for a second, turned it over behind the net. Here's Daschke in the play to the far side. Cassetti through center ice for Miami, chips it over the UND line right wing. Foul, full five-man change for Miami. First to the far corner. North Dakota picks it up. Moore tips it up the boards for Jandrick. Off the glass, with it here over the line left wing in the Miami zone. That's sending through the circle, no angle to the net. He'll take it to the near corner where Barry strips him of the puck in that near circle. Barry over to Daschke. Scan it here, center ice red line. Dump it over the UND line, right wing. Frisch in the far corner. We'll give it up here for Hain. Chip it through the circle and up the ice with it is Sendin. Sendin right wing feed over the line, right wing into Miami zone. Sanderson break to the net. It went off his backhand. Daschke, a good poke check there to knock it free. Corbett, the center ice feed with it for Miami. Barry stolen away though by Sendin at center ice. So a little cross corner dump into the near side of the Red Hawks zone. Moulton plenty of time to pick it up and make a decision. He'll go cross ice. Cullen over the line, right wing, Savage. North Dakota zone to Red Savage. Far circle, and he had a great chance there for a shot. It was locked up by the stick of Chris Jandrick. It has trickled in on Driscoll, who made the cover. 16:03 to go in the third.
Yeah, that could have been one of Miami's best shots of the night, yeah. Right between the hash marks, high slot there. And with Red Savage, the puck on his stick, you know he's got a great shot. Too bad that the North Dakota stick got in there.
Draw to the left of Driscoll. Red Savage and Connor Ford. This is one back to the far corner and sent out there by Jandrick to the center ice area. Over the line, middle of the ice in the Miami zone. That is Connor Ford. Spins around right point. Let it go through the slot. Far circle. A shot. Clevin in front. It's bouncing and it goes in the net. We hear all week about the four or five bounces that don't go the Red Hawks' way in games. There is another one of those examples. A puck that was sent in front by North Dakota kept deflecting around in the crease. It eventually ended up behind Pearson, and he fell back to knock it in his own net. North Dakota 3, Miami nothing with 15:47 left in the third period.
Yeah, it's pretty obvious that North Dakota has outplayed Miami tonight. They've certainly outshot them almost threefold, but regardless, two of their three goals have been flukes, so a couple of tough bounces for Miami. Really no bounces going their way.
At all. So now Miami is challenging that the play was offside. So this is something that they're gonna review. So again, I have no idea if it was offside or not. I can't remember that far, but that was the announcement by the referee and Cameron Voss. So you will have Eric Frank, the linesman, get in the penalty box in the headset and look and see if this play was offside on the zone entry for North Dakota. Worthwhile challenge, though. I mean,
absolutely. I mean, why not?
That goal could put the game to bed right here. With still plenty of time left in the third, but the way Miami's playing tonight, they're probably not going to produce three goals in 15 minutes if that is what it takes based on what we've seen tonight.
Right, a two-goal deficit, it's not great, but a three-goal deficit feels a whole lot worse.
Yeah.
Definitely a worthwhile challenge for Chris Bergeron.
Yep.
Quick call.
Good goal. So the Fighting Hawks lead it 3-0, and the green sprinkled around the arena in the Sioux uniforms. Love it. And our student retention rate is going down by the minute. Nice draw back in North Dakota zone. It is going to be sent in on Pearson from the North Dakota end. It's Ferner trying to just get it up the ice. It went in on net on Pearson. He covers it up. Draw to his left coming up. 15:40 left in period number three. Schmaltz against Michael Regish in this draw. One back to the right point to Ferner. Spins it near half wall. Caulfield back below the goal line with it here for North Dakota. Takes it over to the far corner. Caulfield hits the brakes at the half wall. Capstick mess with him there. Now Regish, the backhand poke to the near corner. Where with it there is Fletcher. Spins off the glass for Barry. Gets it middle of the ice and here comes Regish. Over the North Dakota line, left wing. Will take it behind the net. And spin it on the back end of the right point. Drive there wide off the stick of Murray. Back to the left point, Daschke. Gave it up for Barry. Murray right point for Miami. Center blue line with it. Daschke, the forehand shot from the line, deflected wide. And squirts up the near wing wall. Fletcher there, got a stick up high. They won't call anything, and North Dakota able to work this off the turnover back in the Miami zone very softly and get a full five-man change. Murray up the near wing boards to center right, trying to hit P.J. Fletcher. And this goes back to Murray on a turnover in the Red Hawks zone. Daskey will pick it up here in the near circle. Cross-ice look, here's Corbett over the line on the right wing. Gave it up there for Cassetti. He was bombed against the boards by Moore. Ness turned it over, spinning the puck over the line right wing with a there for North Dakota was Jackson Coons, and now Miami to work it up from their own zone. Here's Cassetti over the UND line left wing. Got in there with Sanderson behind the goal line. Sanderson picks it up behind the net. Coons here, far half wall, gave it up for Ness. And Ness will skate it over the Red Hawk line left wing. Frisch got a pass near circle. That rip deflected off a shin guard to the far corner. North Dakota in the offensive zone. Ness near corner. Trying to battle there with Moulton. Gave the puck back. Here's Coons in the circle. And that went 5-1 Pearson and then hit the post. No goal. You got a shot off there. Went right between Ludwig's legs. And the Red Hawks will blatantly ice it from their own end here with 13:47 left in the third period.
Yeah, and it looked from here like that one went in. I think Ludwig thought that it went in. He threw his head back in anger, disgust, whatever type of bad emotion that you want to say.
Probably Swedish word for it.
Sure, there were a lot of Swedish words going through his head.
13:47 left in the third. Gerard Ludwig's left. Graham clean win back to the near corner. Moulton can't clear it. So it goes behind the net down to Clement, who's up the right wing boards for Miami. Feeds Cassetti in the center circle. Back in the North Dakota net. Driscoll will play it from his stick. Up the ice, Haynes chips it over the Red Hawk line right wing into the zone behind the Miami net. Capstick there to pick it up. Drazner in the battle as well. Picked up here by Red Savage through the circle. Skates it up the near wing. Through the neutral ice area, over the UND line left wing. We'll chip it into the near corner. Clevin there to grab it. Senden got the puck near half on a backhand feed from Clevin. And they're up the right wing through center. Haynes chips it over the Red Hawk line right wing behind the net. Drazner gave it up for Capstick. Spins it around the boards near half wall. Jandrick there missed that attempt to pick it off. It's Red Savage now near circle of his own end for Miami. Savage up the wing. Barbellini chips it over the UND line left wing. Here's Jandrick with a puck. He will tie up with Barbellini in that near corner. Ford in there as well. Squirts up the near wing boards. Back to the left point, Moulton. Right point with a puck. Here's Cullen. Works it through the circle. Back behind the net. Centering play in front. That went right to North Dakota. The slot 3-on-2 the other way. Over the Miami line right wing. Constantini in the circle. He'll fire a shot. Pad save. Pearson goes to the near corner. Ford on it. To the right point, Ferner. Plays it back behind the Miami net. Constantini. Tied up with Cullen. Constantini trips there. The arms stay down. Puck in the near circle, Miami zone. Barbellini works it out to center ice. Saw backhander. Red Hawks five-man change. Ferner right wing feed for Calder. Over the Miami line. In the near circle feed, Constantini trying to go back to Ford. Ended up at the blue line. Ferner chips it far half wall for Moore. Constantini ends up with a puck in the corner. And here comes Rigich. And we'll chip it off his stick back to center ice up the right wing. And dumping it into the zone is Cooper Moore for North Dakota for the middle of the blue line. Red Hawks are working around the boards here from behind their own net. That was Clement, and it just goes all the way down for an icing.
Yeah, I don't know about you, Patrick, but to me it looks like these Red Hawks have pretty much completely given up.
I'm ready for a nap.
Yeah.
Because that's the mood I'm getting on the ice. 11:48 to go in the third.
Nobody's on the pucks.
Nope.
People are chipping the puck off the glass and not going to get it. There's no point of chipping the puck off the glass if it's just going to land on a North Dakota stick without any pressure.
That was a lazy icing, too. They just spin it around the boards down the ice.
Didn't even look for a pass.
Tie up here in the Miami zone near corner. It's a 3-on-3 battle that's won by the Red Hawks. Barry far corner, far circle with a puck. Gave it up for Rigich. Back for Barry. Right wing feed over the UND line. It's the brakes at the half wall. He was hit hard there. Knocked off the puck by Caulfield. That's just a good hit, but they're going to call it. Maybe it was up high, and now we got shenanigans going on. Far half wall here in the student section. That's the loudest they've been all night. Pushing and shoving and helmets coming off. Everybody's in the party. Officials over there trying to break it up. This comes 11:17 to go into third period. We had a late call coming up on North Dakota that hit. It came on to Barry, who got up. He was on the ice for a little bit, able to get up though and skate to the bench. So everybody's okay injury-wise, we think. But the call here is going to come to Judd Caulfield of North Dakota. I guess a high hit. We'll see what the call is. Referees are talking it over now. Just meaning a timeout, by the way. We'll just keep it right here. UC football is up 38-21.
Wow.
For South Florida.
Wonder if that'll be enough. Get him into that top four.
I don't know.
I think they're going to have to hope for a loss from somebody one of the top four.
Still talking over this call as the ice gets shoveled. These two teams meet tomorrow, game two of the series, 5 o'clock right here, Steve Cady Arena. Just for those that have followed Miami hockey for an extended period of time, you know the Saturday games used to start regularly at 7. They now start at 5 here at home. So we are on the air with you tomorrow at 5 o'clock. For game two of the series between Miami and North Dakota.
Did you ever hear an explanation for that change? Is it a conference thing or a Miami thing?
That's a Miami decision. I don't know. I think the idea is that people weren't going to come spend their Saturday night at a game. They wanted to have a Saturday night, so pushed it up earlier. And it's kind of a trend that other teams are doing across the league. Oh, okay. North Dakota has pushed their Saturday games up an hour to 6 o'clock local time start. And St. Cloud started that a couple years ago. They pushed their Saturday start from 7 to 6. So it's a trend.
A little bit of a national trend there, yeah, or at least an NCHC trend.
Yeah, and I think people just like to get the game over with on Saturday and go on with their lives at a decent hour. They are reviewing this penalty to see if it should be a major against Caulfield. Judd Caulfield from Grand Forks, North Dakota. That's where the University of North Dakota is. 6'3", 207 junior in the Pittsburgh Penguins draft pick who used to play hockey for the U.S. Under-18 National Development Team in Plymouth, Michigan. So here's our call on the penalty review. It's going to be just a two-minute minor for boarding. So that's all they call.
RedHawks have had a couple of pretty good-looking power plays tonight. Kind of, honestly, kind of excited to see what they can do here. Maybe this can inject a little renewed energy into this Miami team.
You would hope. Brought to the left of Driscoll here. He is going to watch North Dakota win his faceoff to begin the Miami power play. Again, just a two-minute minor for boarding against Judd Caulfield. It's cleared all the way back to the RedHawks zone. So this comes with 11:06 to go in the third. Miami with it in their own end, trying to go back down the ice on the PP attempt. Here's Barry for Barbellini over the UND line. Left wing, chips it behind the cage. And it's turned over there right to the stick of Jake Sanderson. Sends it all the way down the ice on Pearson. RedHawks with it in the neutral zone. Barbellini, a bad feed, left wing, trying to go across ice. Hain picked it off, sent it back to center. Barbellini again gets it turned over off his stick by Hain. RedHawks able to work it though with reinforcements over the line on the left wing in the UND zone where a battle ensues up high against the half wall, and it's won by Yonernick, and he'll send it back behind the RedHawk net. 1:06 to go in the power play for Miami. 10:20 left in our third period. North Dakota 3, Miami nothing. Barry in the left wing feed over the line. Comes Barbellini into the UND zone. Yonernick was on it, and the RedHawks unable to stop that clearing attempt from the near half wall of the Fighting Hawk end as Dashke let it go past him at the left point. Back behind the RedHawk net is the puck. Capstick, the right wing feed. Cullen cross ice. Over the line comes Red Savage into the UND zone. Chips it behind the net here for Sanderson. Sanderson's not his own guy, by the way. That's for a North Dakota player, and he'll get it out to center ice. I'm sorry, but I feel like I'm watching an intramural game right now, the way this paces.
Yeah, it's weird. It's just everyone's moving in slow motion.
It's like the intramural games on Thursday night at 11. Here's Capstick, far circle. Cassetti, far half wall with 13 to go on the power play. Here's Red Savage. He hits the brace below the goal line. Slowly passes up right point for Clement. Here's Cullen, near side for Daskus. Works it through the slot. That went off a stick, cleared by the stick of Connor Ford of North Dakota, and the power play comes to an abysmal end for the RedHawks.
RedHawks, no shots on that power play. I would say nothing even remotely close to a shot, actually.
No. 9:03 to go here in the third period. North Dakota with a puck at center ice. Here's Ness over the Red Hawk line, right wing to the near corner. Capstick kind of bumped him off the puck. Cullen with it here. Capstick in the near corner. Spins it off glass, back towards center ice. Ferner with it. Cross ice feed. Moulton picks it off. Right side, Pletsky will chip it into the UND zone behind their goal line. Ferner on the puck here in the corner. Let it go near side for Moore. Up the ice through the circle. Pletsky able to pick that pass. It tipped off. Left point with a Moulton. Down the half wall here for Graham. Cross ice look off the far half wall. It was just given up by Drasner. He didn't choose to go after that pass, so North Dakota will chip this one in behind the Red Hawk net from center ice left wing. Ponce in it, near corner from the Miami zone. Beg your pardon, Nick Ports with a puck, near corner Miami zone. He's gonna work this one up the half wall. Here's Drasner, back behind the net for Monty Graham. Far side for Corbett in the circle. It was picked off there by Pletsky. Here's Moulton for Miami. Gets to center ice, dumps it in on the left wing. Clevin with a far corner here for North Dakota. Less than 8 minutes left in the third. 3-0 Fighting Hawks. Send in the backward skate in over the Red Hawk line right wing. Goes to the middle of the ice. Here is Regish after he batted down a centering pass in midair. Leaves it back below the goal line. Far side, Clevin will spin it off Regish's stick. Regish able to get it back on a deflection. Up high, Daske a shot. Great block there. Right on it with Send it. Clement, far side, Daske in front, Regish. Bouncing puck, couldn't get a stick on it, and Berry rips one wide from the slot. Near circle of the puck, Clement at the point, fires it wide right of the net. Daske here, far half wall with it for Fletcher. Back to the right point, Clement wrists her in. That was a rebound after a bad save by Driscoll, sent wide right by Berry. Yarnick with the puck for North Dakota. Skates over the Red Hawk line, middle of the ice. That shot wide of the net by Hain. And a rim around the boards here to the near side of the ice. Savage with it over the UND line left wing. And Red Savage will let this one go back to center. And he'll just, all by himself, got blown up there at center ice. Penalty coming up on North Dakota. Red Savage took that puck all by himself from the Red Hawk line to the UND line, then back to the center ice circle, and then he got blown up, and then a penalty call.
Yeah, and I think that it speaks to how hard both of these teams are trying right now, that in that 10 or 15 seconds that he was holding the puck, he didn't get touched. No one was near him. He really didn't get pressured at all. A little bit of a lazy end of the third period here between Miami and North Dakota.
That's a good word. So a power play upcoming here for Miami. You look at the North Dakota bench right now, Brad Berry, their head coach, is just giving it to them. And they're up 3-0. I mean, that effort that they've shown is not North Dakota effort. It's kind of interesting to see, but shots on goal favor North Dakota, 30-13. We're in a media timeout right now, 6:49 to go in the third period. North Dakota has won. Let me find the stat real quick. North Dakota has won the last 7 meetings between these two teams.
Wow. Do you remember the last time Miami beat North Dakota?
They have not won since November of 2018.
Okay.
It's North Dakota. I was a senior in high school.
It's a pretty long time.
Yep.
A lot of things has happened since 2018. Miami beating North Dakota, not one of them.
6:49 to go in the third. They got a light show going on, so they got to fix that first. All right, we got that done. It's not Brick Street. It's the hockey game. Draw the right of Driscoll, 2 to go in the power play for Miami. They will start it here on the media timeout. Dylan Moulton left point. Offensive zone win for the Red Hawks. Has it here. He'll fire shot in and score! Top right corner. That was a wrister through traffic for Dylan Moulton. It deflected on its way into the net. Went in top right corner over the glove side of the goaltender at Driscoll. And for Dylan Moulton, that's his first point of the year and first goal of the year. His second career goal. Lead cut to 3-1 North Dakota. 6:40 left in the third. And that came 8 seconds into the power play for Miami. And now we got a review. This is definitely for a high stick. Is that deflected on its way in?
Well, if they call this one back, what do you say everybody just packs it up and heads home after this?
We might. And again, I saw it deflect. I don't know what it deflected off of. Maybe right. It was a high stick, and they're just double-checking to make sure. But Dylan Moulton just got that puck left point, ripped a pretty standard wrist shot in. That Driscoll probably couldn't see because it was through traffic. Quick call. Here we go. Yep. Three to one.
Pretty big roar from the few remaining fans here at Cady Arena.
And they haven't had a whole lot to roar about all night. So the draw at center ice, Red Hawks getting ready for that. Red Savage in the draw.
Has Bray Crowder played a single game this year? Because they just announced him on the assist.
No, he's not even in the lineup tonight. No, that's not right. He's not playing.
That's what I thought.
It's in a stance.
That's like saying Jack Schmelzinger or Patrick Geshan had an assist on that.
They'll change that once they look at the video. Neutral ice draw coming up with Miami offside. 6:35 to go in the third. North Dakota wins his puck back in their own zone. Feed it up the left wing. Constantini over the Red Hawk line. This is chipped back to center. Clevin will spin around and put it back behind the Red Hawk net from the left side at center ice. Pearson rims it around the boards to the near half wall. Bermolini's on it for Miami. Cross ice look over the line right wing comes Ryan Savage, spun it in front of the net. That was a pad save there by Driscoll in the near corner. Red Hawks in the offensive zone. Red Savage, far half wall with a puck. Skates it up toward the middle of the blue line. That shot deflected wide. Penalty coming up. We got bodies down in front of the net. Jack Clement has taken about five cross checks near the upper body. He was face down on the ice. And there are just all kinds of stuff going on in front of the net. You got people hugging people, and the linesmen are both down on the ice and breaking stuff up. Finally calms down.
Jeez.
You had Ryan Savage come in and try to grab number 25 in green in front of the net, who was cross-checking Clement for some reason.
Over and over and over again, while Clement was on
right,
the ground.
And he couldn't defend himself. So that player was Tyler Clevin. Then Ryan Savage came in and tried to hug him and get him away. He got tied up by Chris Jandrick. Both of them crashed to the ice.
And Jandrick had him in a full headlock.
Yep.
Looked like he was trying to strangle him.
The linesman came in. Everybody just fell over, all four people. So, Clevin and Jandrick are in the box for North Dakota. Clement and Ryan Savage are in Miami's penalty box. 5:58 to go in the third. North Dakota 3, Miami 1. And as always, the discussion will have to take place here between the officials to figure out what's the call on everyone. Here we go. They're all minor penalties. So Clement got goaltender interference for 2 minutes on Miami. Ryan Savage got two for roughing. Clevin got two for interference.
Clevin two for interference. Jandrick, they said two for roughing.
Roughing on North Dakota. So we're gonna skate 5-on-5.
That didn't really look coincidental to me. I feel like Miami maybe got a little bit of the short end of the stick there, but when people are shoving.
So we are 5-on-5. There's no man advantage to anybody here on these penalties. Neutralized draw one by Miami. They get into the offensive zone. Sanderson behind the net for Frisch. He's hit hard down there by Fletcher. Fletcher with a puck off the far boards. Back to the line for Cullen. Moulton gets a left point. Slides it wide of the net. Berry behind the net in front. Regis! This shot just wide on Driscoll. And North Dakota able to softly clear it out back to center. With it here is Sanderson over the line to the left wing for North Dakota. Works his way to the far half wall, hits the brakes. Far corner, works it back to the line. Schmaltz, right point Ferner, chips it down low to the corner. And with it there to work it was Coons back behind the net. Potts in front for Coons. Right point is Ferner. He will shoot one from the circle, deflected off a body high. Now it's back to the line for Moore. That one off a skate there of Fletcher back to the center circle. Ferner rims it around the boards, the far half wall. Cullen picks it up there. It was stolen away by Schmaltz. Left it middle of the Red Hawk zone. Corbett is on that. Gets it near wing here for Moulton on the half wall. He'll spin it up the near wing boards past the neutral zone and for an icing call here on Miami as he had Pletsky and Graham in the area of the pass, but it missed both of them. Draw coming back to the Miami end here with 4:49 to go in the third period.
And over the last few minutes, I feel like there's been a little bit of a resurgence in this Miami team. They're playing a little bit harder. Would like to see them continue that for the rest of this game and hopefully into tomorrow as well.
The goal certainly helped that.
I think the extracurriculars probably did a little bit too. All they need to do tomorrow, get in a line brawl right off the bat.
Yeah, good idea.
They'll be all over the ice.
Yeah, an injury problem here with the linesman. Brent Golick went over to Drew Ruckelshaus, the Miami trainer, to get something taped up on his hand.
Almost certainly from ending up on the ice tangled up between.
I think so, yep. Brent Golick told me before the game this will be his last year lining in the NCHC. He's done it 27 years.
Wow.
In college hockey.
Wow. That's impressive.
Yep. Draw to the left of Ludwig Pearson. Jonernick and Graham. One back by Jonernick to send a near corner. He'll fire a bad angle shot. Pearson got his chest on that. Hinsky far circle for Miami. Behind the net with it is Moulton. We're going to whistle behind the play for a penalty here. High stick. Who's it against? They got Pletsky. So Chase Pletsky will get a high-sticking minor. We have 4:39 to go in period number three. North Dakota 3, Miami 1. And we'll take the timeout. Power play coming up for North Dakota when we return. They're up by 2. This is Miami Hockey on Red Hawk Radio. Two-minute power play coming up for North Dakota on the Chase Pletsky minor for high sticking. Patrick Escher, Jack Schmelzinger back with the Eric Goggin Ice Center. 4:39 to go, third period, 3-1 North Dakota over Miami. Draw to the right of Pearson in the North Dakota offensive zone, fighting Hawks. The clean win back to the line. Down the wing is Schmaltz, back to the left point, Sanderson for Gaber, top of the near circle. He'll feed it across, went off Red Savage's stick. To the far corner, picked up there by Drasser, who's going to work it out to center ice. So Gamer with it in the center circle, chips it over the line on the left wing in the Miami zone on the far side of the ice. Forward on it there, will get it left point. And on the puck is Sanderson. Down to the far corner is Schmaltz. Returns to Sanderson, left point. Through that far circle in front, a rip there by Connor Ford, went to the near half wall. With it is Gamer. He'll just take his time here near half wall, looking for somewhere to go. Schmaltz got the feed, left point with it. Sanderson back to Schmaltz, center blue line, fan on that shot. Sanderson here back for Schmaltz, far circle, back to Sanderson. They'll work it through the far circle with 105 to go on the North Dakota power play. Sanderson far corner for Caulfield. Back for Sanderson far half wall. They just working on that North Dakota left wing. And a pass there through the circle picked off by Barbellini and sent all the way down the ice on the clear. Driscoll with it behind his own net for North Dakota. They have 44 to go on the power play. 3:20 left in our third period. It's 3-1 Fighting Hawks. First with it over the blue line in the Miami zone. And he was stripped of the puck there by Regish. We'll spin it and clear it all the way back to the North Dakota end. Yonernick gave it up here for Moore. In his own end here for North Dakota. The toss back for Constantini. Frisch, backhand play in behind the Miami net. Pearson on it, stopped it with a stick, and rims it around the boards near side, but it goes out of play too high. A rare mistake by Ludwig Pearson. 14 to go in the power play, 2:53 to go in the third, 3-1 North Dakota.
And if there's one thing Miami can take away from this game, even though North Dakota did score on one of their four so far power play opportunities, I feel like Miami has done a pretty good job. Active sticks, getting their sticks in lanes, deflecting passes all night on the penalty kill. A pretty decent part of the game tonight for the Redhawks.
It has, really, I mean, it has been. If you go back and analyze it. Toronto left to Pearson, one by Miami. Here they go through center ice. Over the line right wing is Graham into the UND zone. That went off a stanchion. He tried to rim it around the glass. It deflected off the stanchion far corner in on Driscoll's net. You had Hain come in from the far corner. He's a North Dakota player. And knee his goaltender accidentally in the head as he skated through. So Driscoll a bit shaken up, but he's all right. And we will see the draw to his left.
Hain didn't even go and say anything to Driscoll either. Kind of weird.
It's a good pickup.
What's that?
It's a good pickup.
Yeah.
Good observation. Rhett Savage in this trap for Miami with Connor Ford in North Dakota. One back by the Fighting Hawks. Jandrick's going to send it out of the zone for the far corner back to Miami. And they have pulled Pearson. In a 3-1 game with 2.5 to go in the third. 6-on-5. The empty net for Miami. Clement for Rhett Savage. Chips it over the UND line. Left wing. Barbellini leaves it there in the circle with a high stick. In front, Ryan Savage with a shot. Another save by Driscoll on the rebound. And he covers up. On the left post with 2:14 to go in the third. Drock coming to his left. And a 3-1 lead for North Dakota. And the net is empty to our right, where Ludwig Pearson is on the Miami bench. So the draw to the left of Driscoll. Rhett Savage in it for Miami against Connor Ford of North Dakota. 2:14 to go, third period. Draws one by the Fighting Hawks, far corner. Sanderson will clear it, splitting the defense down the ice. It goes in the net. Jake Sanderson scores from below his own goal line. A clear that split the defense at the line, the UND line, and made its way all the way down the sheet into the net, the vacant net of Miami. 4-1 North Dakota with 2:07 to go in the third.
How about adding insult to injury? You think he meant to do that, Sanderson?
I think he meant just get it out, but
yeah,
the guy's
right.
So good that.
Yeah, really, he can't mess up if he tries to.
Dakota with a puck here in their own zone, up by 3 with 2 to go in the third. And that's gave it up for Cullen. Kind of trouble Miami getting it into the zone. They will. Over the line on the right side, Regish in the circle, let it go behind the net. Back to the near half wall, pin up against the boards there. It was Gaber. Butcher here in the corner. Works it out for Sanderson. He'll try to work this one back in the backhand. Fletcher there with it. He will lose it in the circle. That's where the puck was. Ports. Looks it out through center ice, down the line. Cullen with it in the Miami end. And this is, I don't even know where the puck is now. It's in the equipment of number 20 in green, Nick Ports, and they blow the play dead. He got stuck in his pants, I think. And nobody knew where the puck was there for a second. They're all banging into each other, and the clock stops with 1:25 to go in the third. Draw coming to Pearson's left.
I like the sad tunes coming from the Miami band right
this
now.
This has been they like to play this song at this moment in games.
Like right before we lose?
It's like, okay, here we go again. Throwing back to the line, Frisch here for Jandrick. Frisch, a bomb went off his own man's body in the slot. That was Calder. 1:12 to go in the third. Corbett with it here in the near corner of Miami zone. Drazzer ties up with him in a battle. Jandrick joins a party up, so he's Jandrick. And it's finally Chiffrey up the corner with a minute to go in the third. Back to the right point, Frisch. Let it go out of the zone. It kind of took a weird bounce off his stick. And it's back in the UNDN. First we'll chip it over to Constantini. On the Red Hawk line right away for Jandrick. Spins it around the boards to the far corner. Calder's here on the puck. Let's it go in the near corner for Jandrick. Skates it up the wing, back to the right point for Frisch. Left point Constantini with a puck in the slot. Lost control, this one trickles out. Back to the neutral zone with 30 left in the third period. Frisch in his own end with a puck for North Dakota. Left wing feed. Here comes Jandrick. Over the Red Hawk line, left wing. Trying to work his way past Clement. Clement just ties it up against the boards. 13 to go in the third period. A little battle here as it's locked up in that far corner of the Miami zone. 6 seconds left. Puck comes free. Back to the line. North Dakota with a last second chance in the slot. Calder fired it in on Pearson, who makes the save. And will cover up with a 1.1 seconds left in the third. And now is the time where everyone hits the exits. If you wanted to beat the traffic, too late.
Too late.
Clean win, Miami, but the time will expire in period number three on the draw to the left of Pearson. And North Dakota comes into Oxford and takes game one of the series by a 4-1 count on the Miami RedHawks. Game two tomorrow at 5:00 right here at Steve Cady Arena. And the number 7 team in the country comes into Oxford and takes care of business and does so in a commanding way.
Yeah, that's right. Not a great showing from Miami tonight. It didn't seem like a particularly great showing from North Dakota either, although they did end up the victors in this one. Miami just didn't really put it all out there tonight, it felt like. Felt like they had a little bit of an extra gear that they could have hit, and they did not hit it. And as so, they exit the ice right now, losing 4-1.
I'll always love when North Dakota goes off the ice after a game, and all the green heads over to the visiting tunnel.
Wow.
It's pretty amazing to see. It's like the NHL or it's like an NFL game, you know. When teams exit the ice, all the green uniforms that people are wearing in the stands head off the ice. And Bradbury's squad looked pretty good tonight. You could argue Jack probably wasn't their best game, but they do put together the win in Oxford on the road. And if you're the Redhawks, I mean, try to diagnose this loss. And the bottom line is the effort, the enthusiasm, the whatever spark, the word you choose to use, whatever word you want to use, it was not there at any moment tonight.
Yeah, the team really honestly just looks sluggish. Really, I'd say the best that they played, there was that one power play in the second period where they got 5 or 6 shots off. That was a great 2 minutes. Before that, they didn't play good. After that, they didn't play good.
Yep.
They came back a little bit more after that fight down there with the Savage, Ryan Savage. But, they're going to need to get going. They're going to need to be able to get going without there being fisticuffs on the ice.
Yeah, Ludwig Pearson, I think, is your player of the game tonight. I mean, he played great, as always, as advertised in the Miami net. And a Red Hawk team that, again, they think they're right there. They think they're close. They think they can do it. I'm not saying that they're wrong, but after tonight, there's going to be a lot of conversations going on in that locker room simply about, do you want to be here? And it just looks like they don't want to.
Yeah, it does. And, you know, we've had a lot of conversations this year, especially you and me, about how this culture, we feel like it's changing. We feel like it's different from last year where we saw a lot of guys did not want to be here. I felt that way up until tonight. After tonight, I'm not so sure.
Yeah, it was very telling tonight to watch this team playing their second home game of the year and really not show up for the game, to be quite honest with you. and a 4-1 loss to the nation's seventh-ranked team in North Dakota. It was competitive, a few stretches here and there in the game, but really nothing doing for the RedHawks on the ice tonight over the Fighting Hawks. Final numbers, shots on goal favor North Dakota, 32-16. So my math's correct. North Dakota had twice as many shots as Miami tonight. Power play, Miami 1-for-4, North Dakota 1-for-5. Faceoffs won by North Dakota, 36-22.
Wow. That must have been a bad third period in the faceoff circle for the RedHawks. It was pretty close after the second.
I remember that. And Miami 12 block shots, North Dakota 6. Penalty minutes led by Miami in the game. 14-12 third period scoring summary for this game was the empty net goal by Jake Sanderson. They gave Connor Ford the assist. That was 17:53 into the third. Miami had their lone goal, Dylan Moulton on the power play. PJ Fletcher, Will Cullen the assist. 13:20 into the third period, and 4:13 into the third period. Matteo Costantini at even strength, the assist to Tyler Clevin and Connor Ford for North Dakota. That's a goal that made it 3-0, and then 3-1 on the Moulton goal. The empty netter made it 4-1. North Dakota, that Costantini kid. You're going to be watching him at Key Bank Center here pretty soon.
That's right. I'm pretty excited for that. Sabres are going to be looking good in a few years.
Yeah, they were looking good tonight. What was the final tonight?
It was 3-2 Sabres last time I checked.
Game still going on ESPN Plus. I know we got listeners in Buffalo tonight, and they want to know what the score is.
3-2 Sabres. 5 minutes and 28 seconds left. All right. Dylan Cousins already scored 2 goals. The future is bright.
Future's bright. That's for sure. Kevin Adams stood right there where you're standing once. So
I believe
he maybe wore that headset, too. I don't know. But 4-1 the final tonight. North Dakota over Miami. Final thoughts?
I got nothing.
All right.
Talk to you tomorrow.
Yeah, we're back tomorrow, 5 o'clock on the air for game 2 of the series between North Dakota and Miami. RedHawks trying to get something out of this weekend with the Fighting Hawks on the ice. Again, 5 o'clock Eastern time tomorrow. So until then, for Jack Schmelzinger, everyone else working hard behind the scenes, Patrick Geshan saying so long. Good night from Goggin Ice Center this evening. RedHawks fall, and another one, their record falls to 2-6-1, 1-2-0 in the NCHC. Until tomorrow, have a great night, and thank you so much for listening, everybody, to Miami Hockey on Red Hawk Radio.